My name is Vikram Singh and I'm a documentary filmmaker. I'm with a wildlife photographer called Yashas Narayan in the Ranthambore Tiger Reserve in India. His challenge here is to photograph tigers and mine is to make a film about it. And the only cameras we're using are the ones on the back of the Samsung Galaxy S21 Ultra. The phone has four cameras that allow us to shoot a variety of scenes. And of course, its size and speed mean it's always ready, which is crucial for fast-moving wildlife photography. In this video, you'll get a peek behind the scenes of how Yashas and I collaborated to make a film about the incredible tigers of Ranthambore. In order to track tigers, you need to start early morning.
Wow.
I was worried how the phone would handle low light, but not only did it work great, Yashas even managed to get photos of the moon using the 100x zoom.
I'm really impressed with the image quality and the subject lock is really helpful in taking pictures like this. Now, let's see if we can shoot some tigers today.
That because of the size of the device, because it's a phone, you can have it, you know, be ready to shoot any angle within a second.
You don't need to change lenses, you don't really need to switch cards or anything like that. Just pick it up and start shooting the moment you hear something. We just heard a sambar call and we're now going to go and see if we can find out the source of it. Maybe there's a tiger nearby. Let's find out.
So usually cats are territorial animals. So we as tracker, we know what area they stay in. On safaris, we go to these areas and we switch off car at every road, every junction inside this area. And we will be waiting to hear warning calls. We also look out for tracks and signs. So we look out for pug marks. So all these things are crucial while tracking cats.
As we were driving, we heard some more strong warning calls. It meant a tiger was on the move.
We heard strong warning calls of deer from down here. So we rushed here and there are still calls down there. Probably the tiger is moving, but we don't know in which direction the tiger is moving. So we just need to wait and see. So we are back in the patience game again.
Soon it became clear that we had a great chance of a tiger sighting. For me, this was the crucial moment we had been preparing for. Everything had to work perfectly for us to get the right shots. This was such a critical moment and everything happened so fast. This was the biggest test for the phone. Could it help us capture the sighting properly in both photo and video? Yashas used the 8K video snap mode, which is a really handy feature that allows you to get high resolution photos while recording 8K video. I also managed to get some great footage in 4K, and the optical zoom was really impressive.
How was that?
Wow, what a nice sighting. It was just amazing. It was just us. You know, we heard warning calls, and the diggers were looking down, looking in one direction. We just, turned our car and started moving.
We'd managed to get some great shots and so had Yashas, but the tiger was still on the move and we had the chance to get an even more spectacular sighting.
Okay, let's try and track the tiger again. See, there's water here.
That's the tigress. It's walking straight in front of cameras. I had to get a wide shot and I had to get a shot of Yashas, taking his photographs, and then as it goes past, immediately I had to switch, and I could switch to 3x zoom, and there she goes, she crouches, and wow, I just didn't expect that to happen. What an incredible privilege for us to have seen tigers in their natural habitat, and to have witnessed something like the hunt up close. It is a reminder that protecting these magnificent animals needs to be a priority for all of us. We cannot take them for granted.
You could have the best specifications on paper, but how does it perform in real life in critical situations? That's the real test of any piece of equipment. And I have to say, we took this phone out into the jungle And this beast more than holds its own.